Good morning students. Today we will solve questions in regard with chapter 6 force and pressure. Now worksheet 6.4. Answer the following questions. Why does a person weigh lesser on the moon than he does on earth? Because gravitational force is directly proportional to the masses of the objects. So earth having more mass exerts more gravitational force on an object, results in more weight. But moon having less mass exerts less gravitational force on the same object, results in less weight. Second, state any three effects of force on an object. Force can change the state of the object from rest to motion, motion to rest. Second, force can change the speed of the object. Third, force can change the direction of the object. Third, list any two real life situations in which pressure plays a role. When we cut an apple with a knife, then we apply force on the unit area of the sharp edge of the apple, which creates high pressure, and this high pressure cut the apple. Second, when we press an awl pin or drawing pin into the display board, then we apply force on the unit area of the pointed end or sharp end of the drawing pin, which creates high pressure due to which it gets pierced into the drawing board. Number 4. Describe what kind of resultant force will be acting on a body when two forces of unequal magnitudes act on it in opposite directions. See, when two forces which are unequal in magnitudes or values acting on same object in opposite direction, then the net or resultant force acting on the object is the difference between the two forces, and that object will move in the direction of the greater force. Question number 5. Explain how objects acquire positive or negative charges. When two objects are rubbed against each other, then electrons from one object get transferred to another object. Object which loses electrons get positively charged, and object which gains electrons gets negatively charged. 6. Explain how atmospheric pressure helps us suck liquids through straws. This I already told in previous class. When we put a straw in any liquid, then its one end is dipped into the liquid and another end is free, which is towards our mouth. Then with the help of our mouth, we suck or pull out air present in the straw, which creates a vacuum or vacant area in the straw. So to balance outside pressure with the inside pressure, because now no air is in the straw, so air pressure decreases in the straw, and outside there is air, so air pressure increases outside the straw. So to balance outside pressure with the inside pressure, a pressure is exerted on liquid which pulls it up. So now liquid pressure balances the air pressure. Worksheet advanced 6.5. For each of the cases given below, draw a diagram on the box given on the right showing the direction and magnitude of the resultant force that would act on the box. Now, in very first part, it is given that there is a box and a force of 26 Newton is applied towards left and a force of 41 Newton is applied towards right on the same object. So, there are two unequal and opposite force are acting on the same object. So, F resultant means resultant force or net force acting on the object will be the difference between these two forces. We will consider this force as F1 and this force as F2. Now, F resultant will be the difference between these two forces. So, the difference between these two forces, F2 minus F1. F2 41 Newton minus F1 26 Newton. What will be the answer? Answer is 15 Newton. So, what is the resultant force or net force acting on the object? That is 15 Newton. And what will be the direction of this resultant or net force? It will be equal to the direction of greater force. So, the net or resultant force acting on the object is 15 Newton and its direction is same to that of the direction of greater force, that is in the direction of F2. Now in second part, two unequal forces 38 Newton and 19 Newton are acting on the same object in same direction. Now what is the net resultant force? Net resultant force acting on the object is the sum of these forces. So F resultant is F1 plus F2. F1 38 Newton plus F2 19 Newton. It will be equal to 57 Newton. And what will be the direction of this net resultant force? It will be in the same direction to that of F1 and F2. So we can draw a figure like this. So net resultant force acting on this object is 57 Newton, which is having same direction to that of F1 and F2. Now third part. There are two unequal forces, 7 Newton and 50 Newton, acting on the same object in same direction. In this case also, F resultant means resultant or net force acting on this object is the sum of these forces. That is F1 plus F2. F1, 7 Newton plus F2, 50 Newton. Then answer is 57 Newton. So, net or resultant force of 57 Newton is acting on the object and this object moves in the same direction to that of F1 and F2. In fourth part, two forces that are unequal in values, 23 Newton and 44 Newton, are acting on the object in same direction and 67 Newton force is acting in opposite direction. In this case, what is the net or resultant force acting on the object and what is its direction? First of all, we will consider this force as F1, this as F2 and this is F3. In this case, to calculate resultant or net force acting on the object, first of all, we will add these two forces which are in the same direction. That is why we are adding these two forces, because they are in same direction. Then from their sum, we subtract this opposite force, F1 plus F2. F1 23, F2 44, minus F3, 67. 23 plus 44, 67, minus 67. So, 0 Newton force is acting on the object. So, this is the case of balanced forces. Brings no change in the object. So, object remains at the same state. 0 Newton, no change. Now, last part. In this case, object experiences two unequal forces of 75 Newton towards left and 60 Newton towards right. So, there are two unequal forces acting on the object in opposite directions. So, what is the resultant force? F resultant is the difference between these two forces. This is F1, this is F2. So here, how can we calculate difference? F1 minus F2. Remember that always subtract lesser force from the greater force. So here also, to calculate resultant force, we will subtract lesser force from the greater force. So in this way we calculate the difference between these two forces which are unequal and opposite in direction. F1 75 Newton, F2 60 Newton. So resultant force is of 15 Newton. So this object experiences 15 Newton resultant force, which has the direction of greater force, that is F1 towards left. In calculating all these questions, we need to remember that if object experiences two unequal forces from opposite directions, then you have to calculate the difference between these forces in order to find out resultant force acting on the object. And if object experiences unequal forces or equal forces in the same direction, then you have to calculate the sum of these forces, and then you will be able to calculate net or resultant force acting on the object. Now, worksheet 6.6, advanced. Answer the following questions. Question number 1. A. Frictional force always tries to balance the force applied on a body. Do you think this statement is true? Give reason for your answer. Frictional force is a kind of contact force which comes into play when two objects are in direct contact with each other and one is moved over another. Then there is an opposing force between the two objects or surfaces which reduces the motion of moving object. In this way, frictional force tends to oppose the motion of moving object. So in this way, it balances the force applied by that object. And to overcome frictional force, a more unbalanced force is required on the object. B part. A girl is trying to push a sofa kept on a floor. The floor exerts a frictional force of 35 Newton on the sofa towards the left. However, despite the frictional force acting on the sofa, the girl was able to move it. What can you say about the magnitude of the force exerted by the girl? In which direction must she have moved the sofa? In above part, I already told you that frictional force is the opposing force which opposes the motion of the moving object. So to overcome that frictional force, we need to apply more or greater unbalanced force. So here that girl is applying more unbalanced force on that object, on that sofa. That is why that sofa has moved against the frictional force of 35 Newton. It means that girl has applied a more unbalanced force on that sofa. So she has applied a muscular force of more than 35 Newton, which has overcome the frictional force of 35 Newton towards right. Question number 2. Monica and Parul each have an inflated balloon in their hands. Monica pressed the tip of a sharp pencil into her balloon, whereas Parul pressed the balloon with her hands. If both Monica and Parul applied the same amount of force on the balloon, which balloon would burst first? It's obvious that Monica's balloon would burst first, because Monica applies force on sharpened pencil. So Monica applies force on the sharp pointed end of the pencil, which covers very less area on the balloon. So force is applied on very less area, which increases pressure. So due to high pressure, that balloon would burst first. In case of Parul, Parul applies same force but on more area of balloon. So it decreases pressure, and due to less pressure, that balloon would take time for bursting. Reason it is asked, which I have given already. Question number 3. Do you think electrostatic and magnetic forces are similar in any way? Explain your answer. Yes, we think that electrostatic and magnetic forces are similar in some of the ways, such as both forces are non-contact forces. Secondly, both can be repulsive as well as attractive in nature. This is all for today. You have to complete all these exercises in your notebook and workbook. Thank you. Have a nice day.